It's Matt. I guess I want to know what you did to prepare for the mission.
Well, when I was accepted the astronaut corps, I spent about 2.5 years as an astronaut candidate, just training in the basic skills required to be able to be eligible for a mission. And once I was assigned to this mission, I spent another 2.5 years training specifically for this mission, learning the Russian language, space station systems, how to do spacewalks and robotic arm training, all the things that I would need for this particular mission. So in all, to get up here where I am today, it was about a 5-year training flow. And that was spent not only at Johnson Space Center, but with our international partners all over the world, Japan, Canada, in Europe, and in Russia. So it's been a tremendous experience.
Do you guys have internet on the spacecraft? No, because you guys got Instagram, you got Facebooks. What's your handle?
Yeah, we do have internet. It's a little slow, but it's workable. And yeah, it's a great capability to communicate, for things like social media, but also email. And my name on Instagram, which is the same on Twitter, is Station CDR Kelly.
My question is, what do you miss most about being on Earth?
The ability to just kind of go outside to go where you want to go, hop in your car and go out to eat or to just go out for a walk with the family, I think is something that that I do miss, that I guess I didn't really think that would be that I would miss that much with all of the things that we have the ability to do up here.
Being in space for this length of time, are there any punch-ups or anything like that? Or are you prepared to be in close quarters with everyone else?
No, not. I've never encountered that kind of thing. You know, NASA and our international partners do a pretty good job in vetting the people that they send up here, and we're, you know, all pretty, I think, easy to get along with, especially in this environment. You know, those things do happen. I've heard, you know, stories of them happening, but I've never experienced it personally.
Hello, Commander. I just wanted to know, were you a kid that wanted to be an astronaut, or did it happen for you later?
You know, I did, but I grew up in the New York, New Jersey metropolitan area, so I also wanted to play baseball for the Mets and football for the Giants. I did, but it was one of those goals that I never thought I would actually, you know, achieve or be in a position where I could, even be competitive. So it wasn't until later in life, I was in the Navy as a Navy test pilot, that I decided to apply and was fortunate enough to get selected.
Hey, Scott Kelly. I've heard so much about you from this lady right here.
All good, thanks.
But one thing that I'm really, really curious about, I'm hoping you can help me out here. What is the infamous task that a pilot has to do on a shuttle mission? I'm really curious about this, so if you could enlighten me, that would be great.
I think what Tracy is probably joking about by asking that question and talking about is the fact that the pilot of the space shuttle is responsible for the maintenance of the toilet on the space shuttle. And, you know, that might be funny to her, but the reason they have the pilot do that is it's such a critical task, because without a toilet, you know, you're not going anywhere. So they will only entrust that to the most talented and capable person on a spacecraft.
That's really, really good.
Thank you so much.